want to ask a question this morning. Have you ever been accused of something? Have anybody ever accused you of calling them something that caused you to have some discomfort about what they call you? Or have you ever called somebody a name, and the person responded back to you what you had said, now that you're not saying it? How did it make you feel when it came back at you? All of us have accused somebody.
Amen.
All of us have said some things about somebody that we shouldn't have said.
Amen.
Amen. I want us to look at the book of Mark, the 3rd chapter, beginning at verse 20, Mark, the 3rd chapter, beginning at verse 20. Amen. Mark, the 3rd chapter, verse 20, Mark 3 and 20. If you have it, say, I have it. And if you're still looking, say, I'm still looking. And if you don't have a Bible, that's somebody next to you, they should have a Bible. Amen. Those of who you can stand, please stand. We will be having communion immediately after the message. Beginning at verse 20, and it says, and the multitude came together again, so that they could not so much eat bread. Am I in the right place? I'm just making sure y'all are real quiet. But when his own people heard about this, they went out to lay hold of him, for they said, he is out of his mind. And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, he has Beelzebul and demons. Amen. I'm going to stop right there. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The title of the text, have you ever been called or accused of being the devil? Have you ever been called or even been accused of being the devil? Let me go at it another way. Have you ever called anybody or accused somebody of being the devil? You can talk back to me if you want to. Because all of us have called or even accused someone, or someone have called you and accused you of being the devil. Amen. When we get angry at people, so angry at people, we start calling people names. And then, when we call names, whatever is on our angry heart, it just comes out. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But here in this text, the Pharisees and the scribes, they was angry because of your Savior, And my Savior, he was going through towns, healing the sick and raising the dead. And they accused Jesus of being the devil. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So my brothers and my sisters, if Jesus was accused of being the devil, what make you think that people are not going to accuse you of being the devil? We have to be careful how we speak and what we speak against our brothers. The Bible says that we are not to touch thy anointed and do thy prophet no harm. Now a lot of us, when we think about prophet and the anointed, you think more so of the pastor. But if you are a child of God, amen, if you are blood washed, redeemed, child of God, saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, that means that you are an anointed and appointed child of God. Amen. But here in this church, this text here, Jesus was called a Beelzebub. Well, Pastor, what is a Beelzebub? I'm glad you asked. A Beelzebub is considered to be the demons of all demons. So when people call you a Beelzebub, you better watch out. You better watch that person that call you a Beelzebub, because if they call you the demon of all demons, they don't mind jigging you in the back. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. They don't mind. Some of them, they done got so good, they'll do it in your face. I know what I'm talking about. Then Jesus entered a house. And again, a crowd gathered so that he and his disciples was not even able to eat. See, my brothers and my sisters, when you got something that people want, you can't even stay in a house for a little while till they're knocking on your door. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But then they had sent messages to Jesus' mother and his brothers that Jesus has lost his mind. Amen. I don't know about y'all, but I done had a Jesus moment. I'm having one right now. Because in order to preach and teach this gospel, you got to be out of your mind. The Bible says, let this mind be in you. Help me now. Also, as in Christ Jesus. So all of us should have the mind of Christ. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But sometimes we don't have the mind of Christ. Sometimes we say things that we come back and say, I didn't mean to say it, but you said it. I mean, you didn't put the rock in your hand. You didn't threw the rock. Rock done went all the way over here. Wasn't even intended to hit the baby, but that rock done got in the baby, and now the baby don't want to come to church. Lord, I didn't mean to do that. Please forgive me. Then you come to church another Sunday, another week, and you got a bigger rock. It goes all the way back here. Here, Brother Elmo. And all he want to do is just come and have worship. And all he want to do is just praise the Lord. But that rock hit him and caused his spirit to be disturbed. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And then that rock goes all the way over in the motherboard corner. It stirred the whole corner. Now everybody is in commotion. But how many know it just don't stop over there in the motherboard corner? It come on up here in the And they'll smile in each other's faces. Giving praise and reverence and utterance to the Lord. And when they leave here, they're talking about each other. But then that old buzz above, that old rock, it travels all the way over and sit down with the deacons. Get a comfortable seat over here, because he knows if I get a comfortable seat over here, I can cause some problems. Y'all ain't talking to me. Because then he don't stop there, because if he can't come up here and sit among the preachers, because everything filtered from the top. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I don't know about you, my brothers and my sisters, but the word of God said, as for me, in my house, we gonna serve the Lord. Hey, amen. You know, when those key positions, the missionaries and the deacons and the choir and the pastor is out of order, then all of a sudden that thing run down here. And you don't want nobody to sit next to them. They got the whole row. Y'all ain't talking to me this morning. Y'all don't want to hear this morning. The question is, have you ever called or been accused of the devil? My brothers and sisters, we have done some devilish stuff without repentance. Sometimes we do things and we think it's okay, because we've been doing that thing repetitiously over and over and over again. Just like the children in that wandering land passing the same rock and still trying to get water out of it. And God had already blessed it one time. I'm just talking what I'm talking. The Bible says Jesus couldn't even do anything because of the press of the crowd. When free goods and free stuff is being issued out, somebody got a problem. When blessings are, people are being healed of their infirmities and people have received their sight, y'all ain't talking to me. We have a problem. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm taking this. That ain't you, is it? I give that for Pastor Turner. Amen. I like that part right there. Because sometimes you have to ask people the questions. And most of the time, they ain't going to give you the right answer. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you guilty? I ain't going to tell on myself. But here, verse 21, when his family, they heard this, they went to take charge of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, I don't know about you, but I got some crazy folks in my family. Amen. You just don't want to tell you. You don't want to tell you. But I got some crazy folks in my family. Me and my wife sit down and talk about my side, and we talk about her side. I got some crazy folk in my family. Are you hearing what I'm saying? God has delivered them from crack cocaine. God has delivered them from a hellish life, and they go right back like a dog. Lick the same thing that made them sick. Y'all ain't talking to me today. Now they send Jesus' mama and his daddy. And that's something, they go get your mama and your daddy and your brothers, you know, when they think you're crazy. Amen. I often tell the story when my wife thought I was crazy out in the backyard. You remember, baby, when I was there going in circles. I was just going in a circle. Just praying to myself. See, sometimes when you have done something that is displeasing in the eyesight of God, and when you want this thing off of you, it don't make no, never mind how you look. You hear what I'm saying? I mean, if I gotta cry, I'm gonna cry. If I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna shout. But God, you got to get this thing off of me. I'm just saying what I'm saying. They thought I was losing my mind. I had an auntie who used to walk up and down the street with the Bible in her arm. Every day you would see her walking up and down the street. People say, they go crazy, ain't Maddie. That was my auntie. They go crazy, ain't Maddie. We got a couple folks up in Auburn. Every time you see them, they're walking down the street. There's a young preacher by the name of Willie. He walked down the street, had his Bible. He walked everywhere he wanted to go. Matter of fact, Willie ended up at Mount Calvary from Auburn. I don't know how he got there because he can't drive. And people probably say, Willie must be crazy. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And then you might have somebody in this town that every time you see them, they down there in the trash can, digging in the trash can. And he's looking for care so he can have a meal, but you call him crazy. Baby, you just bought 2 paychecks from going into the trash, in the trash can yourself. Y'all ain't talking to me. So they ain't sent for Jesus, mama, and his brothers. And they say to him, he's out of his mind. Even in relationships, when we get upset with each other, we sometimes will say to each other, you must be out of your mind. You crazy. Y'all ain't talking to me. I see some of you nodding your head, been there, done that. But here in verse 22, and the teachers of the law who came down from Jerusalem said, he possessed by Beelzebub. He's possessed by the prince of demons. And he's driving out demons. So Jesus called them and spoke to them in a parable. And Jesus said, how is it possible that a demon could drive out demons? Demons are not in the business of driving out demons. Demons are in the business of putting more demons on you, so you can walk in the anointing that God has for you. Come here, man, by the graveyard. The Bible says that he was filled up with legions of demons. And even the swine, the swine that the demon was cast out of this man, the swine. They had enough sense to go ahead and kill themselves with these demons. Here comes a man possessed with demons, and he falls down before Jesus. And Jesus recognized what's going on the inside of him. And he casts these demons out. Amen. So mama and them thinking that this Jesus, my son, Jesus' brothers is thinking, you know his brother really didn't believe who he was anyway. And then two of your brothers and your sisters, they ain't gonna believe either. But in order for them to become believers, somebody in the house has to become a believer. Because the only Jesus that a lot of folks at your house will ever see is the Jesus they see in you. So if they see a hell raiser at home, is that a trait of what Jesus should look like? So if you're drinking, smoking, dipping, and hanging out all night long, hold on you. Skeeter's still there. You claimed salvation 10 years ago, 30 years ago, and Skeeter's still there. And he ain't your husband. Y'all ain't talking. Must be out of your mind to be claiming salvation and still living a hellish life. Who's the Beelzebub? So Jesus called them and spoke to them in the parable. He said, how can Satan drive out Satan? He said, if a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. Amen. My brothers and my sisters in your house, if your house is divided against itself, if the church house is divided against itself, if the deacons can't get along with the missionaries and the missionaries can't get along with the choir and the choir can't get along with the pastor and the pastor can't get along with none of y'all, then we are Beelzebubs. We are out of our mind. We have got to the point that we don't seek the unction of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has become not God in the house of God. But as for me, in my house, we're going to serve the Lord. So he said, if a house is divided against itself, that house cannot stand. And if Satan opposes himself and is divided, he cannot stand. His end has come. Satan will not go against himself. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But those that call themselves Christian will. We'll go against each other. We'll smile in reservation. and we got the green with it. and before you know it, stabbing each other in the back. Who's crazy? But they call your Savior and my Savior crazy. The Bible says they whipped him all night long. Who's crazy? They said he never said a mumbling word. Most of you would have said something. Who's crazy? They marched him all the way up to Golgotha's hill. And while they marched him, Jesus fell down. He was tired from carrying the cross. But yet still, he carried the cross. Now who crazy? And then when somebody else was there to help him to carry the cross, we find that the man who helped him, he must have been crazy to carry the cross of an accuser that they had called a Beelzebub. See, that man, he was a believer of who Jesus was. Then they finally got him to that place called the Golgotha. And they hung him high and they stretched him wide. Are you hearing what I say? I Somebody said, if Jesus be with me, I'll draw all men unto thee. So I asked the question, who's crazy? I heard him tell John. He said, John, behold my mother. Yes, Lord. And he said, mother, behold John, your son. See, Jesus knew that he was getting ready to get out of here. And he was putting his mother in care of somebody who knew who he was. See, John was the youngest disciple of Jesus. John came in as a young age. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I like this part because there's something about teaching young folks something opposed to old folk. Young folks, they will listen to you sometimes. But old folks can be stubborn as a mule. Y'all ain't talking to me. Old folks, they can have their mind made up on a particular thing. Us men been doing it this way for a long time. The Bible says, John, when they seized Jesus, when Judas gave him the kiss of death, they said, John, he ran till he ran out his coat. See, that's what God is looking for. He's looking for people to run. Run! 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 Y'all ain't talking to me. Y'all ain't talking to me. Sometimes you have to run. But here it is. Jesus is on the cross. And he died for all of us. See, he had to be raised up so that you and I might have the right to the tree of life. Can I help you with something? Being saved, you got to be crazy. You got to be crazy because living a life of sin, there are no roadblocks. You just do it the way you want to do it. But Jesus came and he took away the sin and the stain of death. And he washed all my sin. And now, now, I'm dead. That he died just for me. But that's not the end of the story. The Bible said that all night, Friday night, and all day, Saturday, and all night, Saturday night, but early. Can you say early? See, y'all act like y'all crazy. Can you say early? Hey. You're almost crazy. Can you say early? Hey. Now you gotta sit on your feet and get in your attitude. Can you say early? Hey. Somebody say early. Hey. Early. 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 Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. I'm so glad that he got up when Jesus got up. I got up when Jesus got up. My sickness got up when Jesus got up. My healing got up when Jesus got up. My lying got up when Jesus got up. Everything that I needed from him, it got up. The door to the church is open. I will trust in I will Hallelujah. 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 Anyhow. And let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Amen. As we get ready for communion. Amen. Getting ready for communion. Just wanted to read a little bit. Maybe that's what it was, Minister.